All right, everybody, welcome to episode 8, I believe. I made some substantial upgrades to the base, and I built another ship, so we're going to look through all of that, and then followed by a very, very quick time lapse of all that building, probably 16x minimum, probably 32x, or even 64x, 64x probably. So let's fly into our base. So the first thing I did is I built a little lighthouse. I anchored it at the tallest point of the asteroid, and I gave it some beacons, like not the in-game beacons, but like light beacons. I added some defenses all over my base. As you can see, I added a bomb shelter, another landing pad so we can make our next big ship, hopefully this time a lot bigger. And then I made a little mining pad, and I made a mining ship. And there's a little glitch with the mining ship right now. I don't know why it's glitched, but we'll take a quick look at it. Basically, I added defense turrets everywhere. I guess I need to add one of those underneath, even though there's really nothing on the bottom side to worry about. I guess its ship could hide under there. So let's see if I can get in this. So mining ships are pretty fun. I don't have any landing gear on it because I couldn't really, because I want it to be able to bore tunnels, if that makes sense. You know, I want it to be able to make tunnels. I mean, so I'm actually gonna attempt to make a tunnel through this part of the asteroid. I'm not saving this world, obviously. So, and I've been having issues with this. Okay, they're spinning this time, so I need to turn the volume, well, probably off, so I don't wake anybody up. That's better, because it's 2:30 a.m. So first I need to make sure I'm pointing the right way, and then we can basically just, since it's only got four thrusters, we can just start as like a late Christmas present, so they can all play with me, because I don't want to play with strangers, because I fucking hate griefers. Don't even get me started on the beautiful Minecraft server me and a couple friends had, and we tried to make it open to the public. You know, we got a couple more friends, and then don't get me started. Watching online agrees with me, and they're also complaining about it, and they also don't understand the reason for the change. So as you can see, we drew a nice square hole. It looks great. I love it. I think this ship turned out way better than I had expected. Now, it is a very small hole. It's basically big enough for a hallway, not even big enough for another ship to fly through. So obviously we need a large mining ship, and then we got all these little things down here that we can pick up, so I'm just going to float the ship. I'm not going to pick those up right now because that's boring for you guys to watch me pick up rocks. Apparently, if you just hold T and then sweep your mouse around, you can just continuously pick stuff up. So that's pretty cool. So, yeah, I added some defenses. All along inside here, there's defenses. So basically, the new part, the lighthouse has a spiral staircase up. So I guess I will go up to the top and then we can walk down, because it'd be a lot quicker than trying to walk up. So the new motors are, they're finicky. They don't transfer power, Which makes sense if it's a 360 degree motor, but if the motor, say, only spun 90 degrees, it'd be very easy to attach power cables. So maybe they'll fix that, maybe they won't, but there's a reactor, a block, and then four lights, which are activated. And then there's a defense turret inside, as long as on top. And then our gravity generator, since we are out of our gravity bubble. It'd be nice to have, like, a super large gravity generator. I also wish spaceships would be affected by gravity. That would make so much more sense, developers. No, I'm sure you guys do that to make it easier, unlike KSP, which seems to want to fuck you up the ass with their stupid science bullshit. But anyway, that's weird. Did I do that on purpose? But yeah, I did. Okay, so we got our little spot. Whoa. Savoring. Please wait. Got our little spiral staircase. We can just jump down. We don't have any falling damage right now, thank God. So we have a defense turret here at the door in case somebody tries to come in. And then we can walk over here. And I guess we could have taken a shortcut, but I just kind of want to, you know, walk around. I don't have the sprint button equipped. I probably should make it C. Actually, let's do that right now. I'm thinking about it. Navigation, hold the sprint, C. Because C right now, or the default C is down. And, I mean, it's really, my finger just doesn't bend that way. So... okay, that's better. So we reinforce this, we put some turrets up here, and all this stuff is single-walled, because I didn't really realize that it was so easy to break. I probably should have known better, but, you know, we have defense turrets at the top of every staircase, so if somebody tries to come down the stairs, they're dead. No chance at all. So that's very effective turrets, because they can't see the turret. Well, here, I'll show you again. So they're coming through, they can't see the turret, bam, dead. So, yeah, I keep falling down into the... okay, sorry. So, through our doors, and somebody online was using double doors. I thought that was pretty cool, because then it could be like a simulated airlock. Oh, there's another asteroid down there. I'm going to have to make another little panic room down there. But we're going to walk right past our giant landing pad. It's not even done. I totally forgot to put in the legs to make it look like it's, you know, the gravity's... from the asteroid. I mean, obviously it doesn't work like that, but yeah, so that's pretty cool. So that's a much bigger landing pad, I believe. It might be the same size, close to it, but since it's in the middle of nowhere, we can just land the ship on it, like a big ship, you know, just one landing pad or whatever. So this black box here, the red on the roof means no landing, because there's no landing zone, is the bomb shelter. It is 2 blocks thick. I know... oh, not again. What is the deal? I know you're supposed to use... what's crouch? Can I not crouch on a hill? Oh, it's shift. Okay. I still can't do it. Ah. That's angering. Okay, sorry, real quick. I do not like when things go wrong, obviously. 7. Delete. Nope. Ah, come on. It's not intuitive at all. Man, see, that doesn't even... the window should be in the middle. Well, in my opinion. I mean, obviously, not everybody has the same opinion. What if I do 2, 3, 4? What if I do this? Would that look okay if I, like, this? Oh, that's a... like that. See, that doesn't make sense, though, because now it... Whatever, I give up. Okay, sorry. So, it's kind of dark. I tried to brighten it up. The ambient light really doesn't render right now, because there should be ambient light spilling off of these, and there really isn't. I mean, you can use your jetpack light, which is highly unrealistic, but... you know, I prefer to try not to, unless I'm building. You'll see in the time lapse. So we have storage crates here, you know, food, supplies, whatever. We have our living zone. There's no beds or anything for the game. Our extra gravity generator, a backup reactor, defense turrets. One turret's for the door. One turret's maybe for somebody trying to breach the ceiling, which the ceiling's only 1 block thick. I need to remedy that. The floor's only 1 block thick, but the walls are 2 blocks. So if somebody hits the ceiling, kind of screwed. So there is actually a natural hole in the asteroid, as you'll see. So I built a supplies room, medical, the first time I've ever put anything medical, a defense turret, of course, and then a assembler, so, you know, manufacturer, I guess, And then I put down a refinery, and oh, that was it. I thought, and just a bunch of lights, just cusk. So basically, I what happens if I put inventory? What happens if I put small reactor, small cargo container, refinery? I don't think it does anything. So. Yeah, like, apparently random things spawn in your cargo container. Like, I found gold in one that my friends had blown up. I was like, holy crap, that's gold. Yeah, gold. So, I don't know, that's pretty cool. Sorry, rambling. So, yeah, I mean, I think it's a kind of a neat little addition. I mean, I'm not as fancy as a lot of people who spend a lot of time, or I'm not really that artistic of a person either. So, you know, I'm a logical engineer. All logic, no art. Of course, logic and order in itself can be an art if you have an open mind. So we'll just pretend I'm artistic. Well, I'm really not. There we go. Nope. These stairwells bother me. He climbs up the stairs so slow, too. It's like, is this a joke? Oh, I think I'm stuck. There. Go. Okay. So, I mean, that's it. Next up, I think I'm going to build a large mining ship that's also going to have defenses, maybe. Or maybe just a mining ship, I don't know. Or maybe a mining ship with a that can carry, because apparently there's a copy paste function, so maybe a mining ship, and then I'll copy paste a bunch of those small little mining drills, and then we'll just, you know, go mine a hole through that asteroid and maybe build a secondary base or whatever. So I'm gonna shut up now, and I'm gonna film the last little, whoa, apparently I need more gravity generators. Where's my HUD? No gravity. No gravity. Okay, so just barely at the edge. So that gravity generator down there is probably helping out with that. I can probably stick another one, hide another one under here somewhere. Well, not under, because it might not go the right direction. But yeah, anyway, stay tuned on this video for the time lapse. It's not going to be a long time lapse. It's a lot of time I spent, but I'm going to compress it, probably 64x, which is going to have to be double or triple rendered, 4x, 16x, 64, so probably triple rendered. It'll lose a little bit of quality, and I apologize, but I mean, that's the only way I have to do it right now, because my program only allows me to do 4x acceleration at a time, which is stupid. You know, they want you to buy the pro version, and I'm not doing that, because it's a waste of money. So, yeah, so I'm going to film this last little bit here, and then I will see you guys next time. And please subscribe. It is my birthday, December 21st. Last year was supposed to be Doomsday on my birthday. We had a big party. It's pretty awesome. We didn't have a party this time. I just kind of chilled and ate food and hung out with my friends and stuff. So, yeah, stay tuned. Don't be afraid to drop a comment. I approve all decent comments. If you have a criticism, I'll approve it as long as there's no profanity. I don't like trolls. I don't like bullies. So all my comments are approval only, as I'm sure you've noticed. So drop a comment. It will get approved within a day or two, guaranteed, as long as there's no profanity or just blatant, stupid insults like, fuck you, you're stupid. I get those a lot by obviously spam bots or trolls or people with some serious self-esteem issues. So don't be one of those people. Drop a nice comment. Criticize constructively or compliment. Yeah, you know, feel free to comment, feel free to contribute. If you have something you want me to look at on the Steam Workshop, I will download it and play with it and crash it and whatever. So, yeah, please subscribe, comment, like the like, blah, hit the like button if you liked it, and I will see you guys later.
Mm.